Calrophobia is the fear of clowns, and many people suffer from this. A fear that is over 4,000 years old, and may be due to many factors, such as the makeup, abnormally large features on a smaller frame, or just our imagination playing tricks on us. Before we begin, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Every new sub helps us achieve our goal and keeps us motivated to create new content. With that being said, I'm your host, Jamie, and here are 10 terrifying clowns in films. Number 1. It, Pennywise. Tim Curry and Bill Skarsgård both portrayed Pennywise, and both were terrifying in their own right. Tim Curry initially comes on scene as this happy, child-friendly clown who just happened to get lost from the circus and somehow ended up in the sewer. His head is white and bulbous with bright red tufts of hair and a big old red nose that is until he reveals his true face. A mouth filled with sharp, jagged teeth and glowing deadlight eyes. Skarsgård, on the other hand, is a more classical version of the clown. Since he began his charade back in the 1800s and never bothered to modernize his look, it really adds a major creep factor to his aesthetic. A pale grayish Victorian era clown suit with red orange curly hair and a mouth that stretches across his face in an unnerving manner. The legend goes that Pennywise is a trans-dimensional shapeshifter who's been around for centuries, consuming children, and sometimes adults, every 27 years, by appearing to them as a clown, mainly to lure them in. He often takes on the forms of their worst fears to raise the adrenaline levels, which he sees as salting the meat. If you find yourself floating around, head over to Prime, Apple TV, Google Play, or Fandango to pop that balloon. Number 2. The Brave Little Toaster. Evil Firefighter Clown. Remember those clowns from the original animated Dumbo? Imagine those clowns coming into one entity, wielding a hose and a fork, with bright red hair coming out in the shapes of horns from under an old fireman's helmet, donning the iconic yellow jacket and a smile that brings the movie Smile to shame. Probably the most insignificant part of the entire story, this clown by far was the scariest thing in this film, and there are tons of topics that can frighten the faint of heart. It's just a few old appliances out to look for their master and come into some sticky situations with some questionable music along the way. These guys go all out, sacrificing themselves for the group on several occasions. But this toaster has a nightmare of his master getting carried away by smoke. And this clown firefighter comes in, daring Toaster to run. And once he does, the firefighter sprays Toaster and disappears. But his alarming laugh is heard throughout the scene, ultimately causing Toaster to drop into a tub of water, jarring him awake. Such a short scene for a terrifying moment that traumatized many kids. But make sure to take an adventure on YouTube to see it in all its glory. Number 3. Terrifier. Art the Clown. Little is known about the origins of Art the Clown, which makes him that much more terrifying. A tall, slender man donning a white bald cap, white makeup with accents of black, making his features sink in and making his eyes that much more noticeable. Complete the look with an old-time jester costume, which is totally black and white, just makes him seem to not be from this time period. His mannerisms, though, tie everything together, and we have this completely insane creature. At first, he just seems like he's down on his luck, almost homeless, if you will. carrying around that large black trash bag. But after a run-in with others, the hunt is on. And not a lot is left to the imagination. On Halloween night, two friends leave a party, drunk, and go to a little pizzeria where they run into Art. And he seems to have found a fascination with one of the girls. However, it's too late after he's kicked out for anybody in the area. He found his target and nothing will stop him now. Or will they get the upper hand? Make sure to check out this ominous clown and his shenanigans over on Tubi, Peacock, Roku, Zumo, Fandango, Plex, Google Play, Fubo, Prime, or Apple TV. Number 4. House of a Thousand Corpses. Captain Spaulding. Picture a dark, rural road winding through the Texas country, and you stumble upon an oddity of a gas station that doubles as a museum for monsters and mayhem. Enter Captain Spaulding. Vibrant blue eyeshadow all the way up his white face to the tips of his painted eyebrows. With a scraggly beard and rotten teeth, all claiming his entity. As soon as he speaks, the vulgarity spewing out of his mouth, mixed with a tad of psychotic, you almost want to run in fear. The menacing look in his eyes behind those words make shivers crawl up your spine ever so slowly. Top it off with homicidal tendencies and nowhere for unsuspecting visitors to run. We have the making of the most terrifying serial killer clown. Now, he leads those naive travelers to the house of hell, where many corpses are. But which body is real and which is fake? Take the journey over to Tubi, Pluto, Plex, AMC Plus, VIX, Prime, Google Play, Apple TV, or Fandango, if you dare. Number 5. Clown, the Cloyne. Clowns at a children's birthday party are often seen. They come with great ways of entertaining children. Or so we thought. Kent is a real estate agent who orders a clown to show up for his son's birthday party. But that clown is double booked, leaving Kent to figure out how to get a new one ASAP. He finds a costume in the basement of a property he's selling and finds himself in quite a dilemma. Surprising all the kids at the birthday party, we have the rainbow hair, red ball nose, and a very icy costume, with all its blues and whites coming together to make him look friendly. However, the next day, he is unable to take it off, becoming the clown ever so slightly with each passing moment. With an endless hunger, even after devouring all the food in his home, he tries to befriend another child, when an accident happens, killing the boy and giving Kent a taste for what he really wants. No child is safe, even his unborn child. To satisfy your need for a good scare, head over to Tubi, Pluto, Roku, Plex, Fandango, Google Play, Apple TV, or Prime. Number 6. Spawn, the Violator. A plump little man with a blue face that peeks into horns above his eyes. Three white tufts of hair coming out each side of his head and on top. Donning a leather jacket and striped shirt with carnivorous teeth and a diabolical laugh engulfed this being, making him the most uncomfortable. Coming from hell, he's not only mischievous, he's calculated, wanting his side to win and only his side. Angels against demons, pawning off humans as the grunts in the war, we could never imagine. But when the humans maintain their right of free will, the demons don't like this. And the Violator is no exception to this rule. He follows Spawn around, making him do his bidding. All the while, he's pinning another against Spawn, leading to an all-out brawl between the two, and one transforming into a giant bug-like creature. Which one will win? We have already seen Spawn die and come back from hell, only to realize everything he knew and loved has moved on. So it's up to him to decide which path to take. Come take a peek at the Guardian Angel, the Clown from Hell, over on Fandango, Google Play, Apple TV, or Prime.
Hey folks, sorry to interrupt, but we just launched our very own merch store at fatninja.shop. We sell everything from t-shirts, hoodies, mugs, and more, so we would greatly appreciate it if you checked it out. All the proceeds go to our future projects, so it helps us make any kind of, you know, movies and short films that we want to make in the future. So if you got time, check out fatninja.shop. Thanks again, and back to the video.
Number 7. He Who Gets Slapped. The Clown. It's the 1920s, and circuses are all the rage, especially with all the clowns and their happy little hijinks, and especially for one particular clown whose whole skit is to be slapped by his fellow entertainers. Completely black and white, with the old clown style, his smile is almost similar to the Joker. And he's smart. Probably smarter than those who humiliated him just years prior, making him transform into this character. Though he is no murderer in this film, he does bring about the destruction of the two that hurt him the most, with the help of a lion and a sealed room. Paul was initially a brilliant scientist who was trying to prove his theories, and when he does, the Baron takes credit. And his wife leaves him for the Baron. After confessing his love to another performer, he learns she is to be married to the same Baron, and he locks them all in a room that a lion can escape into if one door is opened. Take a peek at this one over on Tubi, Plex, or Prime. It's a slap happy good time. Number 8. The Clown at Midnight. The Killer Clown. An old opera house should be nothing to be feared. However, this one becomes the playground for our killer clown. Dressed in a black, white, and red suit, with a red mohawk, starry eyes, and a disheveled mouth painted in red, we have the perfect scare. Especially with that stare as he tilts his head down, eyes glued on its victim, and a smile that edges up his face. Kate has learned that her mother was a victim of a murder here, who her real father is, and hopefully escape this terrifying place, away from all the dangers that lurk just behind the corner and in the dark. Make sure to check this out over on Tubi, Roku, Crackle, Fubo, Philo, or Prime. And keep the lights on. Number 9. Gacy. John Wayne Gacy. A typical middle-aged man with a loving wife and children sit at the table when lunch is interrupted by neighbors and employees. He quickly becomes enraged. One night, he's driving down the road and abducts a young man, only to let him loose after Gacy had a turn. Then there is the celebration where we see the clown and what he has become. With his red cap, gray eyes, oversized smile, and a red and white costume, he seems friendly enough. However, this is the perfect disguise to get some teens to his house, where he goes on to torture them in various manners, ultimately leading to those visitors' untimely death, stuffing them all in the crawl space in his garage. The connection is made as to why there is a rancid smell emanating from their property. What makes this even worse is that it is based off a true criminal who was executed for his crimes on May 10th, 1994. So for some real life drama and terror from the man next door, check this out over on Tubi, Hoopla, Zumo, Plex, Roku, Fandango, Apple TV, or Prime. Number 10, Extro, the Dwarf Clown. Toys turning into live people is a fear some of us have. Mix that with chondrophobia and achondroplasia phobia, and the true workings of a hellish nightmare come true. Standing only at 4 feet 3 inches, with red curly hair and a smile that is just odd, and feet that are as large as skis. Complete the look with an abnormally large red bow tie, next to a yellow and blue jacket with dark blue pants and red shoes. He is ever so awkward. Spinning light up top seem very innocent, until we see that the clown uses the off hair as an incubator. After Tony's dad was abducted by aliens 3 years prior and returns, Tony is bitten by the dad and develops some interesting abilities, such as bringing toys to life to enact revenge on his neighbor, au pair, and mother's new boyfriend. Don't forget to get lost in this film over on Shudder or Prime. Thanks for checking out the video. Did we leave any films off the list? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Don't forget to tap that bell icon to stay up to date with our latest releases. You can reach out to us on Twitter or X at Studios Fat, or chat with us on Discord, linked below. Make sure to check out our very own merch store located at fatninja.shop. All proceeds go towards our next film project, so we'd greatly appreciate it. I've been your host, Jamie. Thanks again. See you in the next one.